Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Physio Trends. This video I have specially made to give you 5 key points to take away from my live session with Neha on Instagram. Now let me tell you that Neha is already settled in Canada since last 4 years and she is already working as a physical therapist, and I'm going to give you those points which I learned about Canada and physiotherapy. So let's start with point number one. Most of us always ask us that if you want to go to Canada after BPT, which all courses you should select. And as she has suggested, we all should go for master courses rather than going for the PG diploma. It doesn't mean that PG diploma courses are not good, but if you are doing master courses, it is going to add some value to your knowledge as well as for your job profile. So master's degree courses mainly done in Canada are master's in kinesiology and health science, master's in kinematics, as well as master's in health administration, or as PG diploma in health and wellness. So all these courses adds a value to your knowledge as well as it can add up value to your job profile. Point number two, which provinces are better to go for out of 10 provinces in Canada? So according to our interaction, I found out that there are mainly 4 main provinces where you can go and settle very easily because the culture over there is multicultural. Out of them, the first province is Ontario. Second one is Toronto, which basically is just near to each other. Third one is Ottawa. Fourth one, which she has referred, is British Columbia. And fifth one she added to it was Quebec. So if you are going to this 5 provinces, you might get better opportunities to work as a physical therapist. Third and most important point which we discussed was about PCE. So what is PCE, how much time it takes to prepare for PCE, as well as what type of questions are asked in PCE. So let me give you a brief idea. PCE is a basically license exam that all the physical therapists have to appear for and clear it to practice as a physiotherapist in Canada. So this exam, basically we can give it from anywhere, especially like if you want to give it from India, you can give it from India, you can give it from Canada as well. But she suggested that it is better we give this exam after going to Canada. Second point is, okay, how much time it may take to prepare for PCE and when you can give PCE. So according to the guidelines, you can appear for the PCE after BPT from India or any other country. You just have to follow the credentials, like you have to do the CAPR process. If the credentials are done already, you can appear for PCE. And also we have discussed that there are only 3 attempts for PCE, and after that you are not allowed to give PCE exam, which means if you are failing the 3 attempts, then you can never work as a physical therapist in Canada. Another point about PCE, what we discussed was how much time it may take to prepare for PCE. So according to her, if you are studying religiously for 4 months properly about the basics of physiotherapy, then it should be sufficient to clear PCE exam. What kind of questions are asked in PCE? So yes, definitely in the question type, something like this, that there will be a paragraph given about a patient's condition, and from that following 2-3 questions will be asked on the basis of that, the case and situation of the patient. Doesn't mean that the answer is hiding in the question or the paragraph. You have to use your abilities and thinking process to find out the correct answer and choose the correct answer. Here mainly Canadian government focuses on the patient's safety, so more questions will be related to patient's safety in compared to checking your knowledge. So you have to make sure that whatever you study, you are studying in concern of patient's safety. Fourth point what we have discussed about Canada is direct work permit available for physiotherapists from outside Canada. Now for that, we have got mixed review. She has suggested that don't fall in the fraud things, because there are people who will ask for 20 lakhs, 30 lakh rupees for LMIA process or work visa for Canada, and after that they just run away. So unless and until you clarify all the documents and you trust the person, please don't do that mistake, because work visa to Canada is really difficult to get. It's not the ideal pathway if you want to go to Canada. Fifth important point which we discussed was about the salary of a physical therapist in Canada. So generally, once you clear your PCE as a fresher physiotherapist, you can earn about $35 to $40 per hour. In that, tax is deducted, but this much salary is basic for a physical therapist in any provinces. One more point I would like to add here is, if suppose somebody is doing healthcare administration course, masters in healthcare administration, then their salary also starts somewhere with the $25 to $30 per an hour. So if you are choosing that course, you don't have to appear for the PCE and you can directly work as a healthcare administrator in the Canada. I hope you find these key points very helpful for your Canada journey. If you want to know more, you can directly watch the full live video on our Instagram channel. Link I will be providing in the description below. Apart from this, if you want to know anything else, please connect to us in the comment section, or else you can directly DM on the Instagram page.